Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today's a bit of a twofer because we're taking a look at two separate things. The first thing is a change to the Apple Podcast app in iOS 17.4, which is coming soon as of the time of recording, and I'm going to show you how I'm sharing that from my iPhone to my Mac to make a really nice screen share using an app called Bezel. Bezel is really cool. It's a one-time purchase, $29, and I find it really useful. It's not going to be useful for everybody, but if you need it, I think it's going to be something you really enjoy. So let's jump to the screen share. Okay, so here we are on the Mac, and you can see I've got my iPhone plugged into my Mac with a wire, and I'm mirroring my screen to the Mac right now. And so let's do the podcasting first. So I am looking at the Town podcast is currently playing, and if I want to go into the transcript, there's a new icon down here in the bottom left. Tap that, and it's a real-time transcript that highlights as it goes, which is really cool. If you hold down on the text anywhere, you can copy that text, select it, report it if there's an issue with that part of the podcast, or you can play. You can also scroll through the whole transcript. If you find a thing you want, tap on that, and it skips directly to that point. That's really cool. You can also search. So if we let the kind of UI fade away, hit the search button, and you can search for anything. I typed Barbie earlier to see if Barbie was mentioned in this, and it is, and it took me right to that point. I can just tap that part and I can go to that part of the podcast. Really cool if you're looking for something specific in a show. I will say one of the big limitations of this is this only works for podcasts that you subscribe to from Apple's podcast directory in the app. This right here is a Patreon feed that I manually added. I added the RSS feed. This one, there's no transcript. It's grayed out. I can't do anything here. So that's a little annoying. But if you subscribe to the show in the Apple Podcasts app, it's going to work great. It's really, really nice. My first impressions are very positive. Now, I'm going to set my phone aside and show you Bezel now. And Bezel is the app that I've used for a few videos actually already on this channel to share what I think is a really high quality screen share of my phone. And I use this for YouTube, but I also use it at work as well for showing things off. It's really nice. So obviously, the main thing is it shows your phone frame around whatever your screen is showing. It works for iPhones, iPod touches, and iPads. So pretty much any Apple mobile device will work here. If we go up here to the settings, you can see I can pin it on top of other windows. So if I open up anything else, the phone will stay on top. That's pretty nice. I can choose whether to have the audio route to the Mac or not. I'm listening to podcasts here, so that would really screw up my audio track. So I'm just going to leave that muted so I don't do anything there. You can actually do recordings, screen recordings. So this is currently in beta as I'm recording this, but if I hit record and then kind of scroll around a little bit here and there and then stop, you're going to see this pop out on the side, and then it's actually going to be in my downloads folder. It's going to give you two files right now in the beta period. I think by the end of it, there'll just be one, but they give you one high quality recording of the screen itself. And then currently the other recording that has some like padding around the edges to show kind of the background, it's really low quality, and I don't know why. So hopefully they'll fix that before it comes out of beta. But this wasn't there just literally minutes ago when I started to record this video. So it's a new feature that they're really working on right now, but will be there if you need it. And then you can change the color of the device. So it'll match your hardware by default. But if I want to switch it to titanium, I can do that. If I open up the settings for the app, there's really not much. You can start it at login automatically. You can always show the app icon in the dock. And you can show it in the toolbar and hide it when you're not using a window. So that's cool. You can see I have beta features enabled. That's the recording right now, so it just saves it to the downloads folder. You can choose what to do when specific devices are plugged in. So if I plug my iPad in, I'm going to do nothing. When I plug my iPhone in, I want it to open this window. So you can add devices as you go. There's the About page, and that's pretty much it. Now, before I go, I did want to mention that you can do something very similar in QuickTime. So if we do a new movie recording, I've actually already pre-selected it, but you can see my iPhone screen, and this is live, you can see it's right here. And you can actually see Bezel is a little quicker at updating. It's not much, but it is a little bit more real-time than QuickTime. But QuickTime does it totally for free. It doesn't do the device border or anything. It does have native recording built in, which is nice. But yeah, if you want a free option, QuickTime is built in and works pretty darn good. But if you want to make it look like a phone, to make it look a little bit more professional, if you have those use cases, I think Bezel is pretty rad. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.